अंकित रेड्डी, हैव पोस्ट ग्रेजुएशन डिग्री इन ज्योग्राफी फ्रॉम उस्मानी यूनिवर्सिटी एंड आई ऑल्सो क्वालिफाइड फॉर यूजीसी नेट एंड आई हैव 4 years ऑफ एक्सपीरियंस फॉर टीचिंग ज्योग्राफी फॉर TSPSC एंड UPSC aspirants. So today, I'll divide our class into 2 sessions. In the first session, we'll discuss how to prepare geography for TSPSC exams. And in the second part, we'll discuss some of the basic concepts related to Telangana geography. Okay. So first of all, we'll discuss how to prepare geography for TSPSC examinations. First, for any examination, you should have clear-cut understanding about the syllabus of that particular exam. You should have clear awareness regarding each and every subtopic of that syllabus. Okay, so after going through the syllabus, you should check the previous year question papers of that particular examination. Why? To check the depth, areas of the examination, to check the depth of the questions and important areas, high yielding areas through which you get the most of questions. Then you have to shortlist the books, shortlist the best books which are available in the market. Choose limited books and revise to the maximum. Then you should also focus on the current affairs, like your recent reports, indexes that is given by the state government or the central government or any authorities of the government. And you should also focus on the current developments related to the topics. Then you have to maintain notes for both the coaching notes, and you also should maintain the personal notes which you make out from reading the standard books. Then for geography, for a subject like geography, visualization is important. So you get many questions based on maps. So maps will help you to solve the map-based questions efficiently. And YouTube videos, the digital videos, for example, which explains about monsoons, winds. So if you watch them, you can visualize the subject. That is a benefit of geography. And at the last, you have to revise and practice. See, if you are preparing for prelims, you should practice MCQs. And if you are preparing for mains, you should practice writing question and answers. Practice is revision and practice is must for any competitive exam. Okay, so first we'll look at the syllabus. So this is the consolidated syllabus for your Telangana geography. This syllabus helps you to prepare for all TSPSC competitive exams geography syllabus. Okay, so the first chapter is about the location and the physical setting of Telangana. So in this chapter, you should focus on the location of Telangana, where Telangana is located, the latitudinal extent of Telangana, the bordering states of Telangana, and the districts of Telangana, some basic data of the districts of Telangana. Okay, and in the second chapter, physiographic divisions of Telangana, you know that Telangana is part of your Deccan Plateau. So Telangana can be divided into 3 physiographic divisions, that is Godavari Basin, Krishna Piedmont, and Telangana Plateau region. So these 3 are the physical divisions of Telangana. So you should focus on the area districts that are covered under this physiographic divisions and their elevation. The third topic is about the climate of Telangana. So in this chapter, you should focus on the climate of Telangana. What type of climate is Telangana? Telangana experiences winds like your monsoons, rainfall statistics. We'll cover all those topics in this chapter. Then in the fourth chapter, the river system in Telangana. You know that in Telangana has two major river systems, that is your Godavari and Krishna. So here you should focus on the origin points of these rivers, meeting points of some its tributaries, states through which this river flows through, districts, length of this river, and important projects on this river and important places on this river. The next topic is the major irrigation project of Telangana. So here in this chapter, you should focus on the classification of irrigation projects, major, minor, and the major minor projects in the state of Telangana. And you should also focus on the current projects which are ongoing. Then the sixth chapter, the soils of India, the soils of Telangana. So here you should focus on the types of soil and the percentage of soils that the area that is covered by the Telangana by particular soil. You should concentrate on red soils, black soils, alluvial soils, and laterite soils. Next, forest of Telangana. So in this chapter, you have to study about the percentage of the Telangana forest in the percentage of forest in Telangana, highest forest covered district, lowest forest covered district, percentage of forest. And you should also focus on national parks, wildlife sanctuaries, national parks, wildlife sanctuaries, and biodiversity, such kind of topics. Then the eighth chapter, energy resources of Telangana. So in this chapter, you have to focus on the types of energy resources, that is renewable and non-renewable. And in non-renewable, you have to majorly focus on thermal and hydropower stations in Telangana and their capacity. And in the ninth chapter, deals with agriculture and allied sector of Telangana. So in this chapter, you have to focus on the types of agriculture, land use pattern in Telangana, what percentage of land is net zone area, what percent of land, cultivated land is irrigated, fallow land, pasture land, all those aspects. And you should also focus on the major crops that are grown in Telangana, types of crop that are grown in Telangana. And you'd also focus on the allied sectors, the animal husbandry, pisciculture, all those aspects of Telangana. Then the 10th chapter is about the industries of Telangana. So in this chapter, you have to focus on the types of industries, agro-based industries, mineral-based industries, major industries of Telangana and their location and locational factors. Okay, then in the 11th chapter that deals with the mineral resources of Telangana. So in this chapter, you have to focus on the major minerals of Telangana. So for example, coal, iron ore, manganese. Some of the districts in Telangana also have uranium. So such kind of mineral resources. Then the 12th chapter deals with tourism and transport of Telangana. So in this chapter, you have to cover the important tourist destinations in Telangana, both pilgrim ecotourism spots, cultural tourism spots, and their importance. And in the transport chapter, you have to focus on road and railway transport in Telangana, national highways, state highways, and the railway connectivity in Telangana. Then the 13th chapter deals with the population in Telangana. So you should focus on the 2011 census and the recent census of 2021. So in this chapter, you have to focus on the population of each district, population of Telangana, density of Telangana, सेक्स रेशियो, लिटरेसी रेट, लाइफ एक्सपेक्टेंसी रेट, IMR, MMR, all those population aspects. Then the last chapter, I should have clear-cut information of 33 districts of Telangana regarding the important places in the state, area covered by that particular district, important place in the district, important persons of those districts, projects, rivers, and national parks in that area. Okay, so this is the quick overview of the Telangana geography for TSPSC exams. Okay, so now I'll get into the types of questions that are asked in the TSPSC examinations related to geography. So in TSPSC examinations, you get four types of questions. One is conceptual questions, factual questions, current affairs based questions, and map based questions. So these are the four types of questions you get in the TSPSC examinations. So I'll give examples for each type of questions. These are the previous year question papers. So the first type of questions is the conceptual questions. So here the question is about the is asking the what is sex ratio. So this is a concept based question. Sex ratio, density, these concepts are based on the concepts. If you don't know the concept, you cannot attempt this question. So here the sex ratio means the number of females per 1,000 males. So this is the sex ratio concept. Then this factual based questions, factual based questions, for example, here in ancient period, which of the following rivers was called as Telivaha? So this is purely a factual question, right? So here the answer is Godavari. So Godavari was known as the Telivaha in ancient scriptures. So this is purely factual questions. There is no concept associated with it. Then the third type of questions is current affairs based questions. So in current affairs based questions, you'll get the questions based on the recent socio-economic outlook of that particular year or previous year, or the recent reports, indexes that are published by both central and state government. Okay, then the fourth type of questions is based on map based questions. So here, for example, Telangana state shares borders with which states? So in order to solve this question, you should have awareness regarding the map of Telangana. What are the boundaries, bordering states of Telangana? What are the bordering districts of Telangana? What are the districts which do not share borders with Telangana, the other neighboring states? So these are the four types of questions you get in TSPSC examination, especially related to geography. So basically, most of the questions you get it from the factual questions. Most of the questions are factual and map based questions. You get current affairs based and concept questions, but the percentage is less. So you have to focus more on factual questions and the map based questions. Okay. So now we'll move to the second part of the session. That is the basic information about the Telangana state. So on June 2nd, 2014, Telangana state came into existence as the 29th state of India. You know this, right? So on June 2nd, 2014, a new state was formed, that is Telangana, which was the 29th state by then. Okay. So you know that Telangana was bifurcated from Andhra Pradesh state. So the total area of the state is 1,12,077 square kilometer. This is the area of Telangana state. Okay, so when the Telangana was formed in 2014, Telangana had only 10 districts. So the number of districts in Telangana state at the time of formation was just 10. Okay, so later in 2016 August, a cabinet committee was formed under the leadership of Muhammad Ali. So this committee suggested for the formation of 17 districts, but because of some agitations, a high power committee was once again formed under the leadership of Keshav Rao. So this committee suggested for 31 districts. So on 11th October 2016, on the auspicious day of Vijayadashami, the total number of districts were increased to 31. So when during the formation, the number of districts were 10. So then they have added 21 and they made it as 31. So as on 11th October 2016, Telangana state had 31 districts. Okay. So later on 17th February 2019, two new districts were added, that is Mulugu and Narayanpet. These are the two districts which were added, Mulugu and Narayanpet. These are the two new districts of Telangana which were added on 17th February 2019. So the total number of districts in Telangana as of now is 33 districts. What are the two new districts? That is Mulugu and Narayanpet. Clear? So there are 33 districts in Telangana. And you should have a clear-cut awareness about the location of the district, where the particular district is located and what are its bordering districts. Okay. For example, Adilabad shares border with Nirmal district and Kumaram Bhim Asifabad district. Similarly, Manchiran district shares border with Kumaram Bhim Asifabad, Nirmal, Jagityal, Pedapalli and Jaishankar Bhuparpalli. So you should have a clear cut understanding of the location of each district and its bordering districts. Okay. Right. So the next topic of discussion is the location of Telangana state, where the Telangana state is located on the India map. Okay. So before getting into this topic, you might know the basic concepts of latitude and longitude. So latitudes are nothing but the lines drawn parallel to the equator are called latitudes, and the lines drawn from pole to pole, they're called as longitudes. And the lines drawn parallel to the equator, they are called as latitudes. Okay, so you know that the 0 degree latitude divides the earth into two hemispheres. The 0 degree latitude divides the earth into two hemispheres, the northern hemisphere and the southern hemisphere. Similarly, the 0 degree longitude divides the earth into two hemispheres, that is the western hemisphere and eastern hemisphere. Okay, so India is located in the northeastern hemisphere, right? Northeastern hemisphere. So India is located in the north latitudes and eastern longitudes. Okay. So the Telangana state is located in the southern part of India, the southern part of India. And what is the latitudinal extent of Telangana? It is 19 degrees, 51 minutes north latitude in the north and 15 degrees 50 minutes north latitude and the south. So Telangana is located between these two latitudes, that is 19 degree 51 minutes north latitude and 15 degree 50 minutes north latitude. This is the latitudinal extent of Telangana. Telangana is located between these two latitudes. Then what is the longitudinal extent of Telangana? So Telangana is located between these two longitudinal longitudes, that is, see here, 77 degrees 15 minutes east longitude. This is the western longitude, and 81 degrees 19 minutes. This is the eastern longitude. So Telangana state is located between these two longitudes, that is 77 degrees 15 minutes east longitude and 81 degrees 19 minutes east longitude in the east. So this is the latitudinal and longitudinal extent of Telangana. This is important. They may ask you these questions in the prelims. Factual question. Okay. Now, next. How many states share border with Telangana? How many states share border with Telangana? So Telangana, the northwestern part of Telangana is, the northwestern part of Telangana shares border with Maharashtra. And the western part of Telangana shares border with Karnataka. And the south and the eastern part of Telangana is bordered by Andhra Pradesh. And the northeastern part of Telangana is shares border with Chhattisgarh. So Telangana shares border with four states: Maharashtra in the northwestern part, Karnataka in the western part, Andhra Pradesh in south and southeast, and Chhattisgarh in the northeast. So four states share border with Telangana. They are Maharashtra, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, and Chhattisgarh. This is important question, and they have asked it in the previous examinations, TSPSC previous examination. Okay, so Telangana is surrounded by the states of Maharashtra in the northwest, Chhattisgarh in the northeast, Karnataka and Maharashtra in the west, and Andhra Pradesh in the east and south. And Telangana is a landlocked state. So what is the meaning of landlocked state? See, if you look at Telangana, Telangana is a landlocked state. It has no access with the sea, right? It has no direct access to the sea. So such type of states are called as landlocked states or countries. The countries which do not have direct access to the sea, or the countries which do not have ports, those countries are called as the landlocked countries or states. So Telangana is called landlocked state because it has no access to the sea or oceans. Okay. So in India, there are five landlocked states which do not state international boundary. For example, if you look at Jammu Kashmir, Jammu Kashmir is also a landlocked state. But here we are discussing the states which are landlocked and landlocked states which do not share international boundary. So along with Telangana, there are four more states which are landlocked: Madhya Pradesh, our neighboring state Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, Haryana. These are the states which are landlocked states and which do not share international boundary. So there are five landlocked states in India, and Telangana is one of it. Okay, so Telangana is a landlocked state. So the next topic, borders of Telangana. Borders of Telangana, or the districts that share border with the other states, the neighboring states. So Maharashtra shares border with the 7 districts of Telangana. Maharashtra state shares border with the 7 districts of Telangana. They are Kamareddy, Nizamabad, Nirmal, Adilabad, Kumaram Bhim Asifabad, Manchirial, and Jaishankar Pooparpalli. So these are the 7 districts which share border with Maharashtra. These are the 7 districts of Telangana which share border with Maharashtra. Okay, then 5 districts of Telangana share border with Karnataka. They are Kamareddy, Sangareddy, Vikarabad, Narayanpet, and Jogulamba Gadwal. These are the 5 districts of Telangana which share border with Karnataka. Okay. Similarly, 2 districts of Telangana share border with Chhattisgarh. They are Mulugu and Bhadradri Kotagulam. Mulugu and Bhadradri Kotagulam are the 2 districts of Telangana which share border with Chhattisgarh. Okay. Then Andhra Pradesh. Andhra Pradesh is located on the south and southeast of Telangana, and 7 districts of Telangana share border with Andhra Pradesh. What are they? Jogulamba Gadwal, Vanaparthi, Nagar Karnool, Nalgonda, Suryapet, Khammam, and Bhadradri Kotagulam. These are the 7 districts which share border with Andhra Pradesh. And if you look at the map, Maharashtra and Andhra Pradesh share border with the maximum districts of Telangana. Okay. So 18 districts share border with 4 neighboring states. So this 18 districts share border with 4 neighboring states. And there are 15 districts in Telangana which do not share border with any state. For example, Siddipet. Siddipet does not share border with any of its neighboring states. Similarly, Medak, Medchal, Yadadri Bhuvanagiri, Rajanna Sirsila, Jagithyal. These are some of the districts which do not share border with any states. So there are 15 districts in Telangana which do not share border with any state, and 18 districts in Telangana which share border with 4 neighboring states. Okay. And if you look at the interstate border, Rangareddy and Siddipet share border with maximum districts. Within the state, Rangareddy and Siddipet share border with the maximum districts. So these districts are located at the interior part of Telangana. Okay. And similarly, Hyderabad, Jogulamba Gadwal, Adilabad share border with minimum number of districts. For example, they only share border with 2 districts. If you look at Adilabad, it shared border with Nirmal and Kumaram Bhim Asifabad. Hyderabad share border with Medical Malkajgiri and Rangareddy. That's it. And if you look at the Jogulamba Gadwal, it shared border with Vanaparthi and Narayanpet. That's it. So this is some basic information related to the borders or the boundaries of Telangana. Okay. Then coming to the area of Telangana. Telangana area is 1,12,770 67 square kilometer, 1,12,077 square kilometer. This is the area of Telangana, which is 3.41% of India, So Telangana is the 11th largest state in India. Area wise, Telangana is the 11th largest state in India as of November 2019. The number of districts in Telangana is 33. What are the two new districts that are added? Mulugu and Narayanpet. Okay, so added on February 17, 2019. Okay, so in terms of districts, Telangana state occupies 9th place in the Indian states. Okay, in number of districts wise, Telangana shares 9th place. Area wise, 11th place. This ranking is important for prelims. Okay, then what are the largest districts in Telangana by area? So they are Nalgonda and Bhadradri Kotagudem. Nalgonda and Bhadradri Kotagudem are the largest districts in Telangana. And what are the smallest districts? Hyderabad, Medchal and Warangal Urban are the smallest districts. Hyderabad is just 192 square kilometer area. As just see, Hyderabad, Medchal and Warangal Urban, these are the smallest districts in Telangana area wise. Okay, right. So at present in India, there are 28 states and 8 union territories. You may confuse here that when Telangana formed, Telangana was the 28th state of India. But why presently we only have 28 states and 8 union territories? Because recently, Jammu Kashmir, which was the state, which was earlier a state, now it has made into union territories. So Jammu Kashmir has been divided into two parts, Jammu Kashmir and Ladakh. Okay, so Jammu Kashmir was earlier a state. In 2019, it was made as union territory. So as a result, we have 28 states and 8 union territories. Okay, so Telangana is the 29th state when it has formed. But currently, there are only 28 states and 8 union territories. Okay. Yeah, that's it for today. We'll meet in the next class and we'll discuss some more important topics related to Telangana geography. Thank you.